against Coventry City. Adams. Pearson. Leeds began the match so brightly and they're trying to do the same at the start of the second half. Sheridan. Was balked, but there was some pushing also at the back post. So Steven Grzovic will have happy memories of this particular goal. It was from this end that he scored here earlier in the season in the league match against Sheffield Wednesday. Good tackle, Greg Downs, and he was fouled after the ball had gone. A tackle that the referee didn't like by Sheridan. Now Coventry are going to take Pickering off. In fact, Downs is back on his feet, so there's no injury worry with him. But the injured Nick Pickering gives way to little Mickey Chin, who scored a crucial cup tie goal this season, the winner in the fifth round at Stoke. Reminding you that Coventry's progress has been spectacular after a straightforward home win over Bolton Wanderers in the third round. They've won away at Manchester United, away at Stoke, who are going so well, and away here against Sheffield Wednesday. And Gin makes his first contribution. Bennett. Regis has gone towards the near post. Kilcline coming in. It was Pearson who met it, then Burrows, stabbed away by Brendan Ormsby. Peak. Well played. In fact, Bennett couldn't quite turn quickly enough.
People like Ashurst and Ormsby have now become conditioned to defending.
Getting the feeling they thought that this would be their year. Well, if it's going to be, they're going to go on to Wembley. Something dramatic has got to happen, and maybe David Bennett has done it here. McGrath's missed it. Mickey Chin has it.
Marty, what must Brendan Ormsby have been thinking about there? He could have played the ball anywhere. Full marks to Benny for persistence, but look at this now. Centre half who hasn't put a foot wrong this half.
McGrath couldn't make contact, but Gin found the corner. And Mervyn Day, you saw, look away there, furious with Brendan Ormsby. Because there's no way that he could allow David Bennett to do that. And Gin, the substitute, has altered the complexion of this FA Cup semi-final. A goal after 68 minutes. defending. Brendan Ormsby has made his way up from the back. No one had liked to put the record straight more than him after the error that helped Coventry to their equaliser. Dealt with by Peake. Ashurst. Coventry a little slow pushing out. Downs, who'd been the last man right on the line. Leeds really weren't quick enough to realise they could have made more forward runs without going offside. And that's understandable after the quite breathtaking pace of this match. Bennett got the better of Adams again, and they're wearing Leeds down on this side of the field. And Bennett, beautifully done. Houghton! And it was Adams who rescued it, because Houghton had a shot that seemed to be going towards an unguarded part of the net until Leeds' bodies were thrown into the line of it. Gin is there, Houghton this time, and he's round there, and he's scored, and Coventry City are into the lead, and Keith Houghton, who is the FA Cup specialist, the player responsible. Billy Bremner is going to make a double substitution. Number 14 on the left of your picture is Keith Edwards, one of the league's most prolific goal scorers, and Peter Haddock, number 12. Pearson comes off for Edwards. Going to take the throw or leave it for Adams. Ashurst. Ready. Now Ritchie. And he's beaten two, Andy Ritchie. Edwards!
I think they deserved it, Leeds. I think they deserved to at least make extra time.